Hi, first grade. We are going to continue on lesson 20, day 4. So today is Monday, even though it is day 4. So here we go. Follow along with me. We're going to begin with a warm-up with the word play. These words you will recognize from the story Little Rabbit's Tale. And what I want you to do with the word apple, says, sky, beaver, goose, and told, I want you to make up some sentences. You can make them silly, you can make them funny, you can put them into a riddle. I just want you to work with them to warm up. So put each word into a new sentence. So you can tell somebody at your house them, but for a challenge, I would like you to write and then draw them. So have a little fun with it and warm them up. Recognizing syllables. Clap the number of syllables in the compound words. So I'm going to say the word and I want you to clap it. Playground, dollhouse, football, swimsuit, backpack. And number 6, I want you to pause here for a moment and I want you to make up your own. Here we go with the words to know, the little cards that I have normally next to my rocking chair. You're going to do whatever kind of movement you would like. You could do jumping jacks, you could do star jumps, you could do push-ups, you could do anything to get your body moving with these words. So remember, you're also going to say them, spell them, and then say them again. Another challenge is put them in a sentence and write them. Also, another idea is to play hangman. Have somebody play hangman with you with these words. Want, door, more, mother, old, try, use, wash. We're going to move on to vocabulary. Calf, flooded, meadow, wade, rippled, swarm. So I want you to think about those words, and I'm going to ask you a few questions and see what you can come up with. How can you make ripples on a pond? Number 2, what kind of insect flies in swarms? And do you think you could hear them coming? Number 3, where can you wade? And why would you wade? So I know we have talked a lot about compound words. We're going to do one last review of them. Please, if you need help on them, email me and I will give you some more resources. Okay, you need to be able to say them. You need to be able to spell them. You need to be able to clap them out, and it will most certainly help you in the long run. So here we go. Pan, cake, pancake. Pan is something you're going to cook on. Cake, something you might have at your birthday. But pancake is something totally different, okay? So you guys know what to do with this. We're going to read them. Row, side, sun, play, bath, tub, shine, boat, in, pen. Okay, so I'm gonna go get a marker and I'm gonna show you exactly what I want you to do. Find two words above that go together to form a compound word. So you're going to pick two of these words. I'm going to do one for you. Sun, shine. Sunshine. You can get a piece of paper and write them. You could just move your finger on the screen. That would be fine. But try to figure out how they go together. The next one, grouping words by sound. This is going to be a listening activity. So if you have a piece of paper, could you also please make these columns that I have? E-A, O-A, and O-W. So you're going to listen to the words that I say and point to which column they belong in. If you have a piece of paper, please write them. Here is the first word. Head. Head. Feather, coat. Window. Meant. Snowflake. Road. Like a dirt road that you might drive on. Breakfast. So think about the sounds, those vowel pairs, and which column would they belong in? That's our review for the phonics section. If you don't already have your decodable reader, the Little Unit 4 book, go ahead and get that. And you're going to turn to page 155. We're going to read the story called Rosebud. The first thing that I want you to do when you see that page is I want you to predict what's going to happen, what characters are going to be in here, what might be the beginning, what might be the middle, what might be the end. All right, take a look at that. Notice any compound words that you might see. You're going to look for the EA words. You're also going to look for three of our high frequency words, more, mother, old. After you read it, I want you to tell what the girl and her mom do on their boat. Here's another challenge for you. Write about a sailing trip you would like to take. Think about all the story elements that should be in a little short story. Who, where are you going? Why are you going? What are you going to bring? What is your boat going to look like? Really open your imagination, and I would love to see pictures. You could draw a boat. Really take a few minutes and work on this activity. Next, your anchor text is in your hardcover book on page 184. You're going to read silly poems. They are a reader's theater in the beginning. Take turns, okay? And remember, we always go back to our essential question. That is why we are reading these stories. Okay, so how can you help a friend who feels sad? In the beginning of silly poems, poetry uses the sounds of words to make pictures in readers' minds and to show feelings. Clap a steady beat for the rhythm. So after you have read silly poems, I want you to think about a few of these questions. How did you feel after reading each poem? Possibly identify words or phrases that made you feel that way. Maybe did you smile after you read a specific word? That would be linked to a feeling you would have. What rhyming words did you find? Maybe you could underline them. Maybe you could write them on a piece of paper. Okay, maybe you could raise your hand like we do in class when you see a rhyming word. Okay, looking at the endings. Then write a silly poem for Respond to Poetry, and that is on page 186. So we also have grammar, and we're going to review the verb be. We are talking about is and are. The rabbit is little. The rabbit are little. Now, the noun here is rabbit. It names one rabbit, the rabbit. The rabbit is little. Over here, the ducks was here. The ducks were here. The noun ducks, name more than one. With that S on the end, that tells us that there are more than one. So it is were. When you're done with this, please do Reader's Notebook, page 74. And that, my friends, is it for today. Please practice your spelling words. I will explain how we're going to do a spelling test tomorrow. So work super hard and then go outside and play.